Good morning, and welcome to chapel. Today is Wednesday, March 31st, 2004. I'm Laurie Kennedy.
And I'm Aaron Blomberg. Please stay tuned for this commercial for which we're not getting paid.
The rest of this broadcast will be presented commercial-free, thanks to our sponsors, the soon-to-be-replaced Student Senate. That's right. Elections will be held next week. Aaron, what's our top story?
The White House agreed on Tuesday to let National Security Advisor Condoleezza Rice publicly testify under oath before the commission investigating the September 11th attacks on the United States. In return, the National Commission on Terrorism Attacks on the United States unanimously agreed to a Bush administration request that Rice's testimony will not set a precedent that would require future White House aides to publicly testify. The White House asserted that any testimony by Rice can occur only with the recognition that the events of September 11th, 2001 present the most extraordinary and unique circumstances. Lori?
In Uzbekistan, police and military clashed with suspected terrorists, including three females who blew themselves up. And 23 people were killed in a third day of violence Tuesday that rattled the capital during a sweep to round up Islamic militants, witnesses and authorities said. Government forces besieged an apartment building near the presidential residence in the northern outskirts of Tashkent for nearly 5 hours after confronting the bombers. Attacks Sunday and Monday killed another 19 people and wounded 26 in the worst unrest in this Muslim country since the secular government became a staunch U.S. ally after the September 11, 2001 attacks. Uzbekistan hosts hundreds of U.S. troops at a military base near the Afghan border.
Due to the time crunch for this episode, the weather, courtesy of the Weather Underground, has been reduced to the following slides and statement.
Thank you. And now on to Fun Bobby with our sports report.
Well, we're going to have a fun sports report today. Well, March Madness, college basketball is clearly the talk of sports world this month. The Final Four has been narrowed down, all exciting teams ready to battle it out for a championship. Duke, Wade's Georgia Tech, Oklahoma State, and the University of Connecticut are all setting their eyes on a championship this weekend in San Antonio. But the most important news this week is the North America versus the World Soccer Game date has been picked. The exciting game of cultures clashing will be held on April 30th at Ben Lippin Soccer Field. Let's take a look at that awesome promotional video. Thank you. There will be a sign-up sheet in the cafeteria for those interested in this historic event. Practice times will also be posted in the Student Center on the Athletic Department Board. In intramurals, the Ultimate Frisbee League had a bye this week. That means they did not play. In last night's basketball game, the faculty staff defeated the juniors 63-62. What a score! That's a high score for a basketball game. That's like college. Let's take a look at some of the action.
Tom Brewer at the top of the key, waves to the crowd's only fan. Taking it up to the key, outside, pass back to Tom, puts it up, it's good, counted for a deuce. Driving the faculty, and it's good for two. Three-pointer, the Ben Lippin coach, count it! A trace, another three-pointer, three-pointer loser.
Well, back to you, Lori.
Thanks, Fun Bobby. In today's Under the Surface, Grace Marie headed out to Charleston to survey the land for the junior-senior. Grace Marie?
Thanks, Lori. Most of you probably recognize this picture from right before spring break. But now that spring break's over, it's time to start focusing our attention on the next big event at CIU, the junior-senior banquet. That's right, the junior-senior, which means you possibly could have a date. And it's not too late to ask quite yet. So we're going to go now and check out what Magnolia Plantation is going to be like. Senior will be starting at 5:30 with the opportunity to come and enjoy the beautiful gardens and scenery here at the Magnolia Plantation. This building behind me is where we're going to be having our dinner, so we're going to go and check it out. Here we are in the carriage house, which as of now is a pretty empty room, but as of April 16th, it will be filled with lovely young ladies and handsome young men to enjoy the junior senior banquet dinner starting at 7:30. And if you get bored, remember you can always come and play on the playground with your date. Couple more bits of information for you guys. The junior class wants to put on a slide presentation for the seniors for a memory video. So if everyone could send their pictures to box 41 to Matt Lehman, we'd greatly appreciate it so we can have a sentimental moment. And second of all, we just want to say thank you to the junior class who did an excellent job of picking a beautiful place for us to hold our junior senior. For those of you who haven't realized it yet, Magnolia Plantations is very close to historical downtown Charleston, and there's a lot of amazing things to do. So we're going to go check out what you can do on any visit to Charleston.
This is one of Charleston's many nice places to take a romantic stroll. We're here across the street from the Fountain and the Pier, which is a great place for you married students, but it's not quite well lit enough for the dating students.
We're here at Ben & Jerry's, another cool place to come. The good thing is we're open until 11 o'clock on Friday nights. Before you ladies who are worried about those calories, as well as myself, what's in it for you, nutritional facts? Not a problem.
Well, I'm here with Charleston Pedicab, and these babies run until 2 a.m. in the morning, so you can come and get one of these rides for 10 minutes, only $3.50 a person. So here we are at the market. It's definitely a romantic place, but it's closed. So don't come here after the junior senior.
We're here at East Bay Coffee House, finally enjoying something warm to get away from the cold outside. As you can see, this is a nice, relaxing place to come in downtown historic Charleston.
There's not enough time in this newscast to tell you about all that you can do in Charleston. As you saw, we stumbled across 8 different things, and all were fairly inexpensive, potentially romantic, and pretty daggum exciting. For all of you, check out Charleston sometime. For those of you going to the junior-senior, don't forget to get your tickets. In following up on Matt Lehman's wedding ring comment in chapel, Lee Bradshaw of Living Image Photography is offering a 10% discount to CIU students who will need their services this summer.
Aaron, what do you think about that?
Hey, that sounds pretty daggum sweet to me. I'd probably need a date, though.
That's good.
That's good. You have time.
Yeah. Lori, what's up with this week's Entertainment Edge?
Aaron, Columbia 2004 is coming. April 2nd through the 4th, students from all over will be taking over the campus. This will affect Friday's class schedule. As you can see, there is no chapel, and the afternoon class times have been bumped up. One of the features for the weekend will be Worship Night, led by Trinity Band. It will be Saturday evening from 9:55 to 11 o'clock in Shortus. Common Ground, or the Snack Shack, will be open immediately following the concert until 12:20.
Also, next Tuesday, April 6th, an evening with Pat will be held in Hoke. Agape Toss, Hodgepodge, Spotlight Zone, New Creation, Ambassador Singers, and Taylor's Trail will all be performing. The evening starts at 7 p.m.
In today's Ask and Answer, a curious Christian writes, Dear CINN, I feel bombarded by the tremendous push of society on my life. Issues like gay rights, the Pledge of Allegiance, the new abortion law. My question is, as a Christian, where should I draw the line? Jeremy, what's your take?
Lori, what curious Christian really is asking is how far is too far? Allow me to use that question to obviously segue into a related topic. We captured Saddam Hussein some time ago, and naturally he isn't talking. What if he has information that could save the lives of soldiers and civilians across the world? Just how far can we go to extract that information from him? Well, the Geneva Convention is pretty clear on how far we can go legally, but what if that isn't enough? After all, you can only yell at someone so much, and they're just not going to tell you anything if they don't have any fear for their safety. To answer your question, to save the lives of innocents, I feel there is nothing you cannot do to the corrupt. I'm not going to fight over definitions here, you know what I mean. It's important to remember that we're on the moral side of a just war. We're not asking Saddam to renounce Islam, we're asking him to spare the lives of children. The question is, are we willing to face the consequences if we don't go far enough? Aaron, Lori?
That's some important stuff. Thanks for your opinion, Jeremy. Lori?
It has been our pleasure to bring you another thought-provoking newscast. Please stay tuned in as the praise team leads us in a time of worship.
Yeah, so you think, Jeremy, you're going to be able to get a date?
Get that date, Aaron. Get on it.